Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala is not a woman to rest on her laurels. At age 66, she's embarking on a new challenge, reforming the World Trade Organization.
I will say that it's both exciting and daunting at the same time to be here, because I take the reins of the WTO at a time of great uncertainty and challenge.
Okonjo-Iweala was appointed the group's new director general Monday after championing her belief in trade's ability to lift people out of poverty.
So the WTO is, at this point in time, is also facing so many challenges. And it's clear to me that deep and wide-ranging reforms are needed. And as I said before, it cannot be business as usual at the WTO.
In her new role, Okonjo-Iweala can mine her impressive experience. Born in Nigeria, her teenage years were marked by civil war. At age 19, she left for the United States, studying development economics first at Harvard, then MIT. She joined the World Bank in 1982, rising to vice president before being called to serve her country. As Nigeria's finance minister, Okonjo-Iweala fought corruption and secured the cancellation of $18 billion worth of foreign debt. She later returned to the World Bank and became chairperson of Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance's board. Her candidacy to lead the WTO had been blocked by former U.S. President Donald Trump, but new President Joe Biden endorsed her, facilitating her appointment. Okonjo-Iweala becomes the first woman and African to lead the trade body. She says her first priority is to get the global economy going again in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic.